Hello and welcome back, guys. This is Ibrahim Quraishi here, and today we are going to do session 30. And today's topic is VM Override. We have done two sessions on DRS already, and you know now what DRS is, a distributed resource scheduler. It's a very important topic. It basically helps your virtual environment to be running in a optimized level. It balances the VMs. With across all your hosts, so basically gives you enough resources, give your VM enough resources. Now, there might be situations where you do not want certain VMs to move, and if you have DRS enabled, how do you make sure certain VMs don't move around or they stick to a certain host? So let's first dive into basically how do you make sure they don't move around, which is today's topic, which is VM Override. So before we begin, just want to remind you guys, thanks a lot for your awesome comments and feedback. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. I post every week and it's on Thursday morning, 10 o'clock. So be sure to subscribe and don't miss out on these important sessions now. So today's agenda is, what is DRS? We have covered that already. I have done two sessions, but I want to briefly touch because it is in directly related to today's topic, which is VM Override. And then we will dive into how to enable VM Override, and we'll dive into a live demo. So distributed resource scheduler, VMware vSphere distributed resource scheduler, as we know as DRS, is the resource scheduler and load balance solution for vSphere. DRS works on cluster of ESX hosts and provide resource management capabilities like load balancing and virtual machine placement. So it basically decides which virtual machine needs to sit where. So we have seen some demos in the past. So what if we have DRS running, and what if we do not want a particular VM to move? It could be a critical VM, it could be an application running which is a SQL one and you do not want them to move around, because you leaving, losing a ping can cause interruption to the workload which is running on that VM. So how do we go around making sure that VM is like some of your VMs are not actually affected by the fully automated DRS which you have done? Well, we have a solution, guys, and it is called VM Overrides. So in some cases you might require DRS to treat some of the VMs as special, which is obvious really, because obviously you don't have workload in your environment same as everything else. You might have some workload, some VMs running which is highly sensitive to network drops, may be highly sensitive to application servers or database servers. So you want them to stick to the VM they're running on, right? So for example, you might decide DRS should not consider a specific VM from generating its recommendation. So basically you don't want it to even consider it, or you might decide DRS should not migrate it at all, as I was saying. So for those special VMs, you can set the VM override options. How do we do that? So here's how we do that. Obviously, we basically first go to edit settings, and then in there you'll find at the menu something called VM override. And when you select add a VM to that, what will happen is this wizard starts coming up. Now in my environment, I don't have anything added, so we'll go and do that. But in this wizard, it will say select VM. Once you select the VM, then basically you get DRS automation level, override, and then you have four options here: disable, manual, partially automated, and fully automated. So this is how you can decide. I do not want that VM to be considered for DRS, then I can say maybe manually automated, so I can do it manually, or I can completely disable it and then click finish. So let's start the demo quickly, and we'll see how it works. So as always, this is my virtual infrastructure. I want to click somewhere else so that I can start from the beginning. So click the cluster, and then when you click the cluster, you can click the configuration, or you can right click on the cluster and click on settings, which takes you back to here, and which is the configuration tab, which is edit settings of the configuration. Over here, if you see on the left hand pane over here, you will see VM overrides. So as you can see, DRS is turned on and I have got fully automated DRS running here. To do the VM override, we just need to select VM override. And as I was saying, I have none of the VMs which are running here added in the override option. To add VMs to override option, click add and then select a particular VM. Maybe I'll want my Photon VM to run where it is, and I do not want any more DRS automation doing around it. So I just select that and I say that I will manually move it when I want to, or I can disable it. I can also set it to partially automated. And also there are other HA options which you can see here. So if vSphere HA action has happened, if the host has crashed, so high availability will power on your VM. So we can say VM restart priority. So you can set it to override and change it from medium to something else. And there's certain features which you can add. We can add a delay if it's a cluster, or if it's basically part of a service and it's like a VApp, then we can set those settings here. Anyway, so this is how we set it. So let's set it to disabled for now and then finish, and then it should come up over here once it stops spinning. Yeah, there you go. That is how you do it. So, and you can see that it is set to disabled, and vSphere HA response is disabled as well by default. So there you go, guys. This is how you set the DRS automation level. If you do want to change it, obviously you can click on it and then just change it to partially automated maybe, and then click OK, and it has changed to partially automated. You could potentially add another one quickly, this one, next, and then I would say override, and then say this is manual. So then now we'll see two, one partially automated and then one manual. So that's about it, guys, and I hope you enjoyed the demo. It was a quick one. Next topic is going to be a different one. We have covered most of these topic which we wanted, so it will be a completely new topic on the next session. So don't forget to reach out to me if you have any questions, and follow my blog. My new website is going to have obviously the blogs which I am following on the YouTube channel as well, so be sure to check them out. I have been writing a really interesting article about DRS. If you are interested, obviously you can check it out on my blog agileops.co.uk. and okay, so the question of the day, guys: what does VM override do if it is disabled on VM in fully automated cluster? That's mouthful as well. So what does VM override do if it is disabled on VM in a fully automated cluster? I should have given a comma there, but yeah. Option A is it moves the VM with the DRS, or it omits the VM from DRS. So give the answer below in the comments, guys, and don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy watching and keep sharing. Cheers, bye.